गुड इवनिंग श्रीमती विशाखा, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग मी टुडे।
नमस्कार, माय प्लेजर टू।
थैंक यू। सो एज यू माइट नो, दिस इज द कंक्लूडिंग एपिसोड ऑफ ए सीरीज वेयर वी हैव ट्राइड टू असेस द ओपिनियन ऑफ परफॉर्मर्स, ऑर्गेनाइजर्स एंड रसिकर्स टू सी इफ वी आर रेडी टू स्टार्ट फिजिकल कॉन्सर्ट्स इन पब्लिक स्पेसेस अगेन। सो I would like to hear from you as a Harikatha exponent, familiar with so many of the ancient texts and familiar with music and the lyrics of much of the songs that we sing, if you have any insight spiritually or philosophically into such a different situation. So this is an unprecedented situation for most of us who are alive today. So if you have any such insight, it would be really nice if you could share it with us.
Sure. So first of all, happy to be meeting all of you, though it's a different kind of a meeting through a podcast. We all personally believe, most of us, that India, our Bharata Desha, is one of the very unique countries which is characterized by its very specific identity of being a vibrant nation. So Bharata Desha, India, is always vibrant, most filled with utsaha, enthusiasm. And that's why we have a lot of utsavans. Every juncture we have utsavans, because the identity, specific identity of our nation is all Indians, Bharatiyas, are characterized of that bubbling energy. And for the last 3-4 months, being completely locked down, the whole world is suffering, of course, yes, but it's very new to us, because we've always been filled with festivities, and this is a completely different situation for us. But just as you asked very rightly about resuming the physical concerts, just not on YouTube Live or on Facebook, very important discussion that we need to take up at this point of time. Very good that you have taken up the point, Srimati Lakshmi Anand, because there must be someone to definitely take this up, because there are a lot of negative notions, as you said. This is going to be the end of classical music or katha or kacheri or the end of the Bharatiya arts. There's going to be no future for arts. Lot of negative emotions, which we cannot completely say no or yes. What are we going to do right now? And have we seen such a kind in the scriptures? So one point that definitely from my side I would like to reiterate is, the well-being of a person is not just the physical well-being. We always have a very important, in fact, a larger important significant status on the mental well-being of a person, which is more important than the physical well-being, because if you are healthy mind-wise, you can come out of any disease physically too. That is, the immunity levels are dependent on the mental levels too. So well-being is not just being physically fit, it's being mentally fit too. So if we don't resume concerts, and if we say this is going to be the end of Carnatic music or the end of katha or the end of satsangams, then the frustration itself will kill you more than the disease. So it's very important that we have to resume. And your question, has this taken place in the past? I'm reminded of a bhakta who recently came to me and said, I'm just sharing her view. She said, we had a similar situation where Srimad Bhagavatam refers to Maheshwara Jwara episode in Dashama Skanda, the 10th canto. 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam talks of Krishna Leela. Srimad Bhagavatam, in the 63rd adhyaya chapter, it talks of a Maheshwara Jwara, COVID symptom. I heard that fever is one of the most common symptoms, right? And there is this Jwara Stuti in Srimad Bhagavata. The Jwara, the fever, goes to Krishna and does a Stuti, a eulogy. It says, Namami, Namami Tvananta Shaktim Paresham Sarvatmanam Kevalam Yapti Matram Vishvotpatti Sthithana Samrodha Hetum Vishvotpatti Sthana Samrodha Hetum Yattad Brahma Brahmalingam Prashantam Kalo Devam Karma Jeeva Swabhavo Dravyam Kshetram Prana Atma Vikaraha. It says, the Jwara says, I salute you, O my Lord Krishna. You are endowed with Ananta Shakti, so much of infinite power. You are the cause of creation, not only creation, dissolution also. So this is a part of his Maya. The Jwara says, all this is a part of your Maya. This Jwara, me, I'm myself a part of your Maya. Because you are not just the cause of creation alone. You are the cause of sustenance and dissolution too. So, whether you call it Kalo, Devam, Karma, Jeeva, Padavyam, Kshetram, Prana, Atma, Vikaraha, Bijaroha, Pravaha, Svan, Mayaisha. So, the Jwara says, whether you call it Kalo, oh, all bad times. The world itself is facing bad times. Kalo, Daivam. Here, Daivam means destiny. We are destined to face this. We are so frustrated. We are destined. Oh no, this is the karma. This is the prarabdha karma. Whether you call it Kalo or Daivam or karma or Jeeva, Swabhava, Dravyam, the body. This is the Sharira that is facing so much of symptoms and problems. Or Prana, Atma, Vikara, whatever you call it. This is all Tvanmayesha. This is your Maya. And when will this Maya get negated? When all of us think about your lotus feet, when all of us cross all this negation through concentrating on positivity, through concentrating on your lotus feet. So instead of filling the cosmos with fear, let us all fill it with positivity. Ena disha mamangalam. I'm reminded of another verse, incidentally, where Uddhava says in Srimad Bhagavatam, Udgayatina Maravinda Lojanam, let us all sing blissfully, happily. Ena Disham Amangalam, let it touch, echo the skies, Divam Asprishad Dhvanihi, let our music touch the skies, so that Ena Disham Amangalam, whatever Amangala, whatever inauspiciousness is filled in the air, let it all go away. Let it all go away and let loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Let the whole world be rid of fear. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha. Let everybody be fearless. So trying to create more and more fear. Of course, we have to be cautious. We can't take it light. Everything is there. But there needs to be a balanced mind. Going on, getting scared and panicky about everything and anything. That fear itself will kill you. Every day is a day to be celebrated. It's a day of joy. And that joy, definitely through YouTube concerts or Facebook, if we have no resort, I think the last resort can be a YouTube concert, a live concert through the virtual digital platforms. But it's just like a hungry person, really starved person, he comes to you and says, please give me food. And you go and show him food, lot of different kinds of food on YouTube. His appetite only will increase. It's going to increase. And you cannot feed him by showing a lot of 20 items on the virtual social media platform. You have to feed him. Even if it's plain rice, it's enough. Even if you have one parikshit. Shuka says, Rasikaha Bhubi Bhavukaha. I need Rasikas before me. You can't manage with the digital platform throughout. There are so many points to this. Right at this point, people are resorting to the virtual platform, the digital platform, because there is no other option. But if there are people contending that this is going to be the norm, we won't have real-time concerts at all. That is a very, very negative idea at all. That will be a full stop to Carnatic music itself, because our music or our katha or our Bharatiya arts, our dance, all this is not a matter of Sharira Dharma. It is a matter of Manodharma, Dharma of Manas. And when does that Manodharma, that imagination or creativity come? When I look at you, when I look at a person, when I look at a living live person, it can be even one person or four people, like how Adi Shankara got four disciples, like how Shukar got one Parikshit. He says, Rasika ha bubi bau kaha. One Rasika is also enough. And four disciples is enough for Adi Shankara. He says, you need that interaction. It's not about just listening. It's not just entertainment. People think that kacheri or katha is an entertainment sector. No. That's why I started this with saying that it is something which treats you mind-wise. If think of the consequences, if there are no physical live concerts, people will get frustrated, not the artists alone, audience, the rasikas, they will get frustrated, they will develop bad habits also. There will be a lot of youngsters and other people who get into a lot of wrong addictions, like in the West. That's what happens in the West. Here, we are generally used to goshtis. It's not a yoga. Yoga is you can go and lock yourself up in a room and do it separately. But for kacheri or katha or all bhakti aspects, you need a goshti, where the joy of performing together, joy of listening together, the rasikas looking at each other's face, if there is an abhaswara or if there is a suswara, if there is a good sangadi, and the joy of the pinching each other, all that, the atmosphere will get charged. It's about receiving and giving energy levels. It's not just about a click of a button and just listening to you do chapatis and then listen to Maya Madagoda, or you rise and listen to Vakula Banamadri. You give your time, energy, soul, heart, the whole 100% of it, the ambience, the audience, the transmission, the vibration, everything. Adinaleda and the Uddhavan Mandir. Yena disham amangalam, the cosmos itself will get charged. So definitely physical concerts have to be resumed. Okay. But it's yeah. So again, I'm reminded of the Saptama Skandam in Srimad Bhagavatam, where the reign of terror by Hiranyakashipu, it was like COVID only. Because no physical concerts. Hiranyakashipu was literally a COVID. It was terrible. So everybody locked inside their houses in fear. In fear of Hiranyakashipu, the devas go and surrender to the Lord, and they ask, when is the end to this? Like how we are asking, when is the end to this? Where is the future? Then the Lord says, Kalam Tavat Pratikshata. Everything has a Kalam. Positive things also have a Kalam. Negative things also have a Kalam. See, in the Olahatla, Tulasi irukkira Olahatla than Kanjeri, beads are also there. The tiger is also there. The cow is also there. There is a time for everything. So, Kalam Tavat Pratikshita, wait for the good times to come back. And it's not too far. It's definitely going to come when that beautiful small little child starts singing. That Prahlada starts singing. Again, Kachit Gayati Ange starts singing and starts chanting my names. Appu and the Prahlada Noda Avataratoda, the good times will start. So, Tyagaraja Swami again, Ragaratna Malika Cheriti Gola, so many other songs. He says, Bhagavatam Tumalu Puri Pada. Ellaroda Kuri is what he always refers to the term bhajana. Bhajana means Vottir Kadayadu. Bhajana means lot of people together. Of course, we have to take precautions that social distancing is there. It's a matter of being careful. I had the feedback of the artists, the rasikas, the organizers. I'm just doing the summary. So the rasikas are also willing to attend. Organizers are also willing to host the performances. Artists are also willing, provided precautions are taken, government relaxes the rules, like how the government is running buses and trains now. 25% capacity, 50% capacity. When buses can run, I think halls are bigger than buses. The smallest hall will also be bigger than a bus, I'm sure. So when buses can function and when trains can run, this is not a matter of essential services, Marida. Concerts, we have to take into account. Because this is the food that many people sustain on. Without satsangam, I will die. COVID will not kill me. Without satsangam, that will kill me. So without positivity, I cannot live. So let's be positive. Let's take the precautions. And there are so many green zones where there is no death, zero death. Like for example, Srirangam, Trichy. Yes, 1%. Affected people are also maximum 20 only. The rest are recovered. So look at the mortality rate. Look at the green zones or red zones or whatever zones. And wherever possible, whichever is the safest place, let's start there. There has to be some start somewhere. Okay, so let's make a start. It's not as worse as the other Western countries. See, the immunity levels of Indians, they say, is good. Let's wait. We have to wait and see. We are not sarvajnas. We don't know everything. But there has to be somebody to build a cat. So that's what you are doing, perhaps.
So are you personally ready to maybe do a satsangam, do a harikatha performance?
Definitely.
Okay. What would you be looking for if somebody were to organize such a program right now in terms of precautions and what arrangements that they make? What would you be personally looking for?
Strictly speaking, I'm not a person who really is very scary or fears everything. Of course, minimum fears will be there. But now, and all the more, I'm not in Chennai. So I'm in Srirangam. So here everything looks very normal. So when malls can start, when restaurants can start, and everything else can start, why the temples should be shut? Why the concerts should be locked down? Why all the positive things which give us energy are all locked down? I don't understand. Those are the things from where we derive the energy levels. We derive hope. So let's... When things look normal right now, after considering the conditions of that particular place, let the government decide. And if it is willing, I'm sure the organizers are willing. I just heard the organizers, they are willing. The Rasikas are willing. They are diehard fans. Diehard na, kekkalena ulipoyidum. Adhan diehard. So we have waited enough, I think, 2-3 months. Of course, definitely, we cannot go and then jump in together like I heard that somebody did a concert in Bangalore some 2-3 months back, and because of one person, so many people getting affected, then the artist's name will also be spoiled. So then somebody will say, Srimati Vishakha Hari said, please resume. That is why I resumed. So there is always people who... definitely, we need to take precautions. We can't take it lightly. All that is there. Anaka, fight it rather than fearing it. Fight it rather than fearing it. That is what the Jwara itself says. Let the Lord restore Kalam Tavat Pratikshata. Let him restore the good times. Let us all surrender at the feet of the Lord and let him show us the path, the future path. I'm no person to say this is good or this is bad. I'm not a sarvajna, but I feel of the Lord, and let like how the Jwara did the stotra, let him show us the path. Nobody knows how the future is going to really look like. This is the reality. It might go on to months, or it might go on to weeks, or it might even be years together. So we cannot decide what is good or what is bad at this point of time. But all that we can do is pray and surrender at the feet of the Lord, like how the Jwara did the stuti and extolled the Lord. I'm surrendering at your feet. Please restore the good times to us. Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu. Let the world, the entire world, see positivity. Let it feel the auspiciousness. Let it become normal again. Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu. Ma kaschid dukkha bhag bhavet. Not a single person should get affected. It's about the life that matters, right? So it's saving lives. This is not entertainment. That is why I heard many people comparing this saving lives versus entertainment. This is not entertainment. This is your mental status. You're trying to treat them mentally, mind-wise. So physical well-being and mind-wise well-being. So this cosmos should not be filled with negativity and fear all the time. That's not good for anybody at all. Always very dull and not very irritating. And why does the day dawn? And the madri irukka kudadu. Every day should be a joyful day. And that only the Lord can. Sarvajna da ananta shaktim. That's why the Dwara says, Namami ananta shaktim. You have so much of supreme power in you. You are endowed with infinite power. So it is up to you to bring everything to normal. And again, promote the arts without kalai and kalvi. Rendu kannu madri. So without the growth of art, the kalai, the utsaham, the utsavams, everything, without all this, India is not India. Let it get, the whole world should come back to normalcy is what I pray on behalf of everybody.
I think the difficulty arises in the fact that the spiritual underpinnings, the philosophy is rather abstract for most common people. Now, on a daily basis, we are faced with so much of news, about the danger. And the danger is twofold. One is that we might contract it ourselves. And then I think there is the other danger that maybe scares people even more to go about going to public spaces, which is that because of our going, other people might get affected. I think it is twofold fear that is holding people back. And it seems to be difficult to hold on to the abstract in the mind, to think that it will get all right. God will look after. I think that's very difficult for most normal people to hold on to when they are so afraid.
Correct. You cannot just say God will take care and ipove ponnu solala. So you have to take it in the right sense. Being impractical is something different. Practical are what we can right now do. Is surrender to him. Avloda na sonnene thavara. Surrender and immediately go and sit in a concert in avane thousands of people. We are not talking about that.
Right.
But taking a small step, infant step, toddler step,
okay,
in green areas, in green zones. That's why I said where the cases are really low, no death rate. That's why with the government permission and the precautions. Let us take a step.
Yeah.
Who is going to take a step? Buses are running. Trains are running, malls are functioning. Mall ikku pogama irukave mudiyada? Restaurant la saapradama irukave mudiyada? Where is the fear?
Right,
why
right.
does the fear come in the concert alone? Those people who are really passionate, they won't get really scared about it. They are passionate about food, so they run to the restaurants. They are passionate about buying, so they go to the malls. If you are passionate enough for music, you will definitely come, even if it is four people. With social distancing, adequate precautions,
right,
with all the facilities, with hygienic conditions. I think, and the zones, I told you that the zones are most important. In a place like Chennai where the cases are going on rising, you cannot do that. But where it's really low, I think you can start resuming.
Thank you so much. I think that has given a lot of clarity. It's nice to hear your views. And also, since you have had an overview of what everybody else said, to have a summary from you and to learn about the spiritual underpinnings of something similar. So this has been very illuminating for all of us and hopefully will provide some comfort to those who might be struggling to assimilate and digest what is going on, which, as I said, it has been unprecedented in the lives of everybody who is currently alive.
Very true.
So, thank you very
and
much.
Upcoming artists also.
Absolutely.
Upcoming artists, this is going to be a really tough time. For people who have already earned a name, they will Google and say, they can look at the YouTubes. But right. For people who are really passionate about music and want to, for upcoming artists, it's definitely, there has to be some step taken in the near future at least.
Right. Thank you very much, Srimati Vishakha. It's been a pleasure to have you.